that we have rough cut all our blanks and have drilled our 21 millimeter hole dead center. Next step is to true up the discs. With the spindle guide removed from our routing table and a straight cutting bit with a roller guide on top, place your jig with that central boss into the center hole there, like so, and with a hammer just gently tap the tops of the screws all the way right round so it bites into the plywood disc. And there we have it. Nice and firm, and your disc is not going to slip against the jig. Ensuring that the bit roller guide is against the outer edge of your jig, we're set to rout and clean up the edge. You will see that the impression made by the screws at the 8 points, these will be the locating points on your disc for the wheel studs. Now go through and do up all 56 of your blank discs like so, and then we'll start with the next process after that. The next step is that we take 28 of these and we put them aside. And the remaining 28, we're going to start to make the profile of our road wheel. With the setup here, I've placed our spindle guide back in with a setting of 93 millimeters from center to center of bit. The bit that we are using here is a half inch, 12.7 millimeter ratted profile bit with the roller guide removed. The router bit is set so that the outside edge of the rad is level with the top of our work tape. What we will be doing is from our first stack of 28 blanks, we are going to route out two pieces which will form the inner and outer core profile. And with our blank piece, turn it upside down. And with our jig, just slip the center boss in like so. And with our quarter inch centering bit that we made up before, place it in the hole that I have, since last time, have drilled at 93 millimeters from center out to here. Just give it a little gentle tap, like so, take it off, move the jig, and you'll be left with a hole to drill here at half inch. Just replace the jig. Just give that a little gentle tap in place, and with 8 small bullet head nails, just give them a little tap all the way right round. There, like so. And the reason we do that is because we intend to make a complete cut to separate the two parts. You'll need something to stabilize the outer section. Now I place the jig center over the spindle, and with the router bit just protruding into the hole that we have just drilled, I'm going to start turning, first off just as a gentle turn to take out part of it, and then continue on down until the whole core is separated from the outer section. The beautiful thing about having clear perspex is that you can see the bit come up and make its cut. Go through and do all 28, and then I'll show you the next step in the assembly. Now before we assemble these, what we're going to do is, from our original stack of 28 that we'd put aside, we're going to take 14. And in the central axis hole here, we are going to rebate a bevel that will allow the wheel bushing to be inserted in to the wheel faceplate. With our spindle guide removed, I have fitted a 45 degree beveling bit with a roller guide, protrudes 8 millimeters. Now with our faceplate disc, I've just drawn a pencil line around it to act as a reminder is that is the face that you've got to route out.
Taking either one of our faceplate types, ones with the rebate or the ones without, we'll make a mark. Now you'll notice that the small pits made by the screws from our router jig, draw a line on the circumference in line with one of those marks and then project it to the rear face with another line like that. This mark is to ensure that when you nail the rear profile piece on, that the nails do not foul the location of where our wheel studs will come through. To align rear profile piece and our wheel plate, I've cut a 19mm polypipe and place that into the centre and then just tap it into place. Now the outside diameter of our 19mm polypipe is 21mm, which is the same as our hole, so we get a nice, neat, firm fit. So when we place our profile piece over, it'll align true to the axis. And with our profile piece, you'll notice that there are indentations again, the same as on the faceplate. Make a mark this time, centre between any two marks. And that'll be the location that you will join the two together.
Apply just ordinary woodworking glue, and what I use is a brush. And just brush it all the way over so it covers the entire surface area for a good bond. Now take our disc, placing it over the top, just give it a tap in place. Give it a turn, like that, it drives any air that's trapped in there out. At the location where these impressions are, we'll now tap the nail in part of the way, lining it up where the start of the rad is and driving it in at an angle. You see, what we're going to do is we are going to drive the nails in at an angle so that they bind, strengthen the central core and prevent it from pulling apart. To ensure that we are not going to build any warp into it, we need to clamp these sides as we nail them. Do the opposite side next. Now with a damp cloth or a damp sponge, wipe any excess glue. And now you understand why we've got the big poly tube in the core. That prevents any glue from building up inside and drying, in which case you would then have to re-bore the centre. And next step is to just make a mark on the outside the rim, approximately in between the locations of your last nail. With a marking gauge set at 10mm, just mark off. And then with the nail, the angle is to be parallel to the outside circumference. Next, outer piece, apply woodworking glue, brush it all over evenly, and with our wheel plate, place it on, ensuring that the outer edges align and match. First off, just when you get the right location, clamp that there on this side, ensuring that it's correct, and just tap it into place. Use the old Mark 1 feeling gauge, your fingers. Just moving your clamp and that's that. Right, reverse it, wipe off any excess glue that has oozed out, and there we have what in actual fact is our bowl shape, which forms the core of our road wheel.